Okay, both the headlamp buckets are back in place. They're loose, though. I haven't tightened them because they've got to kind of work out. Right, I'm reassembling the headlamp buckets on the 69. And these are the only headlamp buckets on the early Mustangs, 65 to 73, that had the quad headlamp setup. So they came, Ford has had a relatively unique idea, engineering idea, when it came to keeping these in. So I'm going to kind of just do a quick little video for those of you that have a car that's disassembled. There's a small retaining spring, has a lot of tension on it, and that goes into this stainless trim ring, and then that gets secured here. It takes a little bit of effort to get it in, and then these are the aiming adjustment screws right here that go to, they are secured within those tabs, and then there's two small stainless screws that hold on to the stainless ring. Now this spring is specifically designed, if you look at this setup here, there's a hole in both the stainless trim ring, and then there's a hole in the bucket itself, the inner bucket. And you can see the way the spring's designed here. It's designed so when you pull down, that also loops into there. So you're catching both. You'll drive yourself crazy if you're trying to figure out how this is supposed to go through both. It doesn't. It goes through both here, and then the spring comes down this way and then gets pulled taut and it goes in here. So I'll show you. This one's already been put together. This is the inner. Both the inner and the outer are the same. So you can see where it's secured here, and then it's secured on the other end. The small J style, I guess it's more than a J, that goes all the way through to this back piece. And this is pop metal. These headlamp buckets are pop metal. If they've ever been wrecked or crunched, man, they're no good. So these are in good shape, fortunately. And these retaining, I'll show you the back on this. Give you an idea here. So here's the back of it. You can see where the retaining spring goes. And then these have all been detailed. Most of the stuff always gets painted over. Then this trim piece is a real devil to get to if it's on the car. So I would say, I don't even know how you would change it. It's not meant to be changed off the car, or when it's on the car, rather. It's very difficult to get to. So, and then it's got the proper new rubbers here. So anyway, I'm going to go ahead and put this other lamp in and show you what it looks like when it's finished. So here's the spring without tension on it. You can see it's lined up to go into both holes there. And I use needle nose. I mean, this seems to have worked pretty well to pull the spring out. You got to hold it with one hand and pull back with the other to get it to a seat. So there it is. Went in pretty painlessly. And now, when you look at the headlamp, it's nice and taut. All right, those are both the right and left headlamp buckets in place. They have to be adjusted. And so I haven't tightened these up yet because these all have to be worked together with the fender, with the lower valance, and with the stone guard that goes across here. So, and then the bumper has to go in too. But at least it's getting a lot closer now that the buckets are kind of on, and I haven't even bolted them on there, and they're relatively close. I mean, this one's off. But the front's much closer now.